The Secretary of State is in North Korea working to nail down specifics of how the regime will comply with the denuclearization deal. Meetings taking place today and tomorrow. It is the first time Mike Pompeo has been back since the historic Singapore summit. Dan Hoffman, a former CIA chief of staff and Fox News contributor, joins me now. Dan, thanks for coming on this morning. Big couple days coming up here. And to remind everybody, it's the third time that Pompeo has met with Kim. But it's the second time they'll be having a one-on-one. What do you expect to come out of this?
Well, first, I would just caution everyone to manage our expectations. This is an extraordinarily complicated diplomatic challenge. It's a good thing that Secretary Pompeo has such experience at CIA and on the House Intel Committee, and that he's brought with him the CIA Korea mission manager, Andrew Kim. At the heart of this debate is whether North Korea will give up its nuclear capability in return for food and energy assistance and integrating its economy into the region and potentially the world.
So Pompeo's there, really, now that the broad framework for denuclearization has been achieved at that Singapore summit, he's there to hash out the details of how to get that done.
Right, exactly. What's missing and what's left to the negotiators, and it certainly makes strategic and tactical sense to do it this way, is to have a timeline for denuclearization and then account for North Korea's nuclear sites. That's an extraordinary challenge. Many of the sites are secret sites. We've got to look at not just the nuclear facilities, but also, I think, tangentially, North Korea's ICBM capability. And let's not forget their chemical and biological weapons as well. They are armed to the teeth. And it presents great challenges for our negotiators.
Obviously, intelligence, something you know well. How will we use our intelligence to determine if Kim is really, truly moving in the direction of denuclearization?
Well, I think sometimes we'll ask him questions to which we know the answer, and we'll see whether he's double dealing. We'll rely on our liaison counterparts, particularly the South Koreans. One of their lawmakers just yesterday provided some satellite intelligence indicating that the North Koreans were seeking to build a nuclear capability to launch from one of their submarines. They've got about 70 submarines in their arsenal. So we'll do all of those things, and then we also need to track on Russia and China, nefarious actors, which are already talking about trying to ratchet down the sanctions before we achieve denuclearization. That's very much against our strategy.
As we know, the economy in North Korea is in free fall. What role will the economy there play in Kim's strategy and what he's willing to agree to with the United States?
I think it's a delicate balance for him. He knows that his economy is extraordinarily weak, and it really does threaten his regime security. At the same time, he's certainly aware of what some economic reform has brought to dictatorships in the past, like the Soviet Union. If you allow too much economic and political reform, you could be toppled. He also knows the value of his nuclear deterrent and the results of those countries like Iraq, Saddam Hussein and Gaddafi, who didn't have a nuclear deterrent and were toppled, he would believe, as a result. So again, it's a delicate balancing act, and for our intelligence community, what it means is that we're not only concerned about North Korea's nuclear capability, their proliferation. Remember that the nuclear site that the Israelis destroyed in 2007 was built by North Korea. We're also concerned about a loose nuke scenario in the event that Kim Jong Un miscalculates and his regime falls from within.
And interestingly enough, the president weighing in at that rally last night on the situation in North Korea and his strategy said at first they thought I was being too tough, especially with his rhetoric, and he was going to cause war with that rhetoric. Now he says people are saying he's being too nice. Listen to him last night.
During the Obama administration, it seemed like a missile a week. I mean, a lot of missiles going up, a lot of rockets going up, a lot of nuclear testing. We had very tough rhetoric. Would you say that was a little tough, right? So remember, they said, he's too tough. He's going to cause a war. It's too tough. Now they say, he's too nice. He's too nice.
Get your reaction to that, Dan.
Well, I'll go back to what I said at the beginning to manage our expectations. Negotiations with the Soviets under President Reagan's extraordinary leadership took years. And what I think the president did at Singapore was establish a broad framework from which Secretary Pompeo can take the lead in these negotiations. Let's look ahead over the coming weeks to see whether we have working groups designed to drill down on some of these key issues, like the inventory of North Korea's nuclear weapons and a timeline for denuclearization, whether we might open up interest sections in Pyongyang and Washington. And then we're still waiting for the remains of U.S. soldiers killed during the war between 1950 and 1953. So we're in the early days, and let's see how it shakes out in the coming weeks and months.